Hi, and welcome back to myexcelonline.com. Today we are going to show you some creative ways to do subtraction in Microsoft Excel. So for this tutorial, we are going to show you how to subtract from a column, how to subtract a sum, and then how to subtract with an absolute reference. And at the end of this video, we have some further training for you, so stick around for that. So let's start with the column subtraction. If you've been using Excel for a while, you've probably seen this one before. This is the simplest way to subtract one cell from another. So if I go into C1 and I type equals, and I click on A1, hit the minus sign, and then click on B1 and hit enter, I can see that I've subtracted B1 from A1. And if I click in C1 and double click right here on the bottom right hand corner where I can see this square, I can autofill and copy that formula all the way down. So if I click here, it's A2 and B2, A3 and B3, etc. My next example is using a sum formula. And this one is actually really creative. If I type equals sum with a left parenthesis, I can see that I can sum several numbers. So the first number I want to sum is this one right here at the very top. And then I'm going to type a comma. And so what I would like to do is I would like to take everything from A2 to A10 and subtract that from my top number. So going back to algebra, subtraction really is a positive number plus a negative number. And so in this case, I want to take the 1,000 and I want to sum that with the negative of the sum from A2 to A10. So I've selected A1 as my first number to sum. And now to put the negative in, I'm just going to do a minus, and then I'm going to click on A2, keep my left mouse button down, and drag all the way to A10, and hit enter. And I can now see 378. And 378 is 1,000 minus the sum of all this. And let's just double check that. If I highlight A2 all the way to A10, down here I can see I'm getting a sum of 622. And if I were to subtract 622 from 1,000, I get this 378 down here. So remember, sometimes subtraction is actually the sum of a positive number and a negative number.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
So the next one we're going to do is absolute reference. And what an absolute reference is, what if I have a cell down here, like an A12, and this is the number I consistently want to subtract from the number that I have, either an A1, A2, A3, etc. So here, I'm going to type equals, and I'm going to click on A1, and then I'm going to subtract what's an A12 and hit enter. However, if I autofill, I'm getting a 50 here. And an 85 here, so nothing's being subtracted from here. That's because my reference is changing. And look right here, A14. I really want it to always be A12. But because Excel anticipates the next cell every time you copy a formula, the A12 is here, but A13 is here, and A14 is here. And I really want those numbers not to change. So if I go up here in B1, and I click before the A, and I hit function F4, I can see that these dollar signs are added before the A and before the 12. So if I hit enter, and then I click on B1, and I double click on this square right here again on the bottom right hand corner to autofill, I can now see I am keeping the absolute reference of A12, even though the A3, the A4, the A5 is changing. And that is exactly what I want. And my final one's a paste special. But this is a bonus one, and we would really like to encourage you to visit our blog. So I'm going to save this one for your visit to our blog. I'm going to include that link below in the description. So if you have any other questions or comments about the other three that we've done, please leave them below, and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching, and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.